Get ready to match the stars. Bill Anderson, Rex Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Palmerstown, USA, Janelle Allen, McLean Stevenson, and Deborah Lee Scott, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
I knew you were hurt yesterday, but we had no idea that Charles had maimed you.
You're all right. Charles hit me yesterday, and I've been bleeding a lot. I had to get bandaged.
I think the whole thing is overdone. They already did Lawrence of Arabia. You're late.
No, now there are other parts I could play.
What?
Invisible
the
mummy.
The sheep.
That's right. Visit
the
invisible man.
Elephant
Very
man.
Fine.
Do you see me as Rudolph Valentino?
I certainly do.
No, I see you as a Ku Klux Klan member that wants to see what he's doing.
Thank you very much, Bill.
When did
the stitches come out in the traditional 8 days. In the meantime, we'll carry on like this. It's going to be all right. Susan McCartney and John Clark may look familiar to you, as I may look familiar to you. And it's because they've been here before, and there was something a little goofy that went on. We said, what the heck, let's give another shot at it. That's what we're doing here. Now, Susan, you remember, is from Hoboken, New Jersey.
No. Laguna Beach, California.
Laguna Beach, California. I knew it was one or the other.
Maybe you came back to the show too soon.
That's right. I got up out of the hospital bed a little too quickly there. And Susan is a dancer, right? And what else you
and
want?
And I'm involved in community theater.
Right.
Straight
right.
Heavy drama.
And John Clark now is from Patchogue, Long Island, right?
That is correct. I am
right.
From Patchogue.
From Patchogue, Long Island.
No, actually, I am from Inglewood, California.
Well, I knew it was one or the other. Patchogue or Inglewood, California. Now, what do you do again, Jan?
I attend school full-time, El Camino College, and I am a music major and broadcasting major.
All right. Good luck to both of you. This is a round one of game one. Susan, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll take A.
A. If my voice sounds muffled to those of you who are just listening to the audio and not watching the picture, it's because my voice is muffled today. I'm losing my bottom. Please, madam. You're tearing my bandage. Are you ready?
Ready.
Here it is. Bob said, in the last election, I didn't like any of the candidates.
Yay!
Yes.
So all I did was go into the voting booth and blank.
I have a joke.
You have a joke?
Well, if Anderson, Reagan, and Carter were in the middle of the ocean sinking, who would be saved?
I don't know who would be saved.
The American people.
Correct. Yeah. Any of the candidates, so all I did was go into the voting booth and blank.
Cry.
Cry.
Good.
All right.
Well, that's your straight drama.
I like it, hon.
Susan says cry.
You get the feeling the Marines have landed out here today?
Yeah.
Hooray! I love a Marine.
Oh,
or is that a parade?
Go.
Well, I cried, but when I got through crying, I threw up.
Uh-huh. That's, rather appropriate, I think, at this moment in history. What have you got?
Well, it's just depressing, isn't it? Tried to commit harikari.
Aha! All right.
So if you viewers want to order the Halston ski mask and ski hat, it is $29.95. It comes in blue, yellow, and red. Wee wee.
Wee wee. All right. Susan is looking for the answer, cry.
Answer?
Answer.
Well, he's harmed now.
They go to the bathroom.
Okay, that's what Charles said. It's all right. What do you say there?
In a desperate effort to get a laugh from Marines, I wrote, pull my lever.
Good answer.
All right.
It looks like you've had a double chin transplant. What is it actually?
Let me remove it.
Yes, sure.
Can we have a roll of the drums while I remove the tape there? Susan, would you like here. To give me a little hand here? Would you come up here, please, and act as the nurse? And
get... da, da, da.
I'll tell you what I need, but we don't have time for that.
You remind me of Joan Crawford in Scarface Woman.
I want you to...
Me when she said that.
No, I meant him.
I want you to unwind me.
Okay.
All right?
I'll unwind your
band. I promise you be gentle, will you? You will call me when we get to New York sometime, won't you? Thank you. All right.
Oh, it's just me.
Just you.
I didn't want to write a lot, so I just used a letter from the alphabet P.
Uh-huh. All right. All I do is go to the voting booth. And, all right. Susan. You did
but
the score.
But I have a bandage.
You have the bandage as a souvenir. All right. Now, John, we have a round one question for you that says, Joe College said, there is a sorority on this campus where the girls are so ugly they don't live in a sorority house, they live in a blank. Joe College said, there's a sorority on this campus where the girls are so ugly, they don't live in a sorority house, they live in a blank.
I think I have the definitive answer.
What's
dog
that?
House.
A dog house.
Dog house.
Dog house would be appropriate. All right.
The spirit of the occasion, I first wrote haunted house, and then I said no, and I wrote dog house.
All right. What he means is, at the moment we happen to be taping this, it's Halloween Eve, isn't it?
No, it is Halloween, period.
It's Halloween.
That's why you wore the mask.
All Hallows Eve. And 1947. Yeah. So this might play 2 years from now someplace. What do you say?
I say the whole bandage bit. Stunk.
No, it was terrible.
You were fabulous, darling. You were incredible. I believe that
I say get rid of her now, this week. This goes on for years. Just get her out. Get Bess Myers.
Get
Arlene.
My pleasure.
Get Kitty Carlisle. Get anybody.
Get Paul Lynde. Doghouse.
We've had Paul Lynde. Doghouse. That's one.
I hope it's a match. Kennel.
Yes, of course.
Oh, my God.
3 for John. You make it 4. Girls is kept a sorority. They don't live in a sorority house. They live in a...
I thought this was the definitive answer. In a cage.
A cage?
Yes.
Yeah. Animals. Keep them caged up, right?
Mm.
You like those animals, McLean?
Yeah, I said cage. I'd like to talk to the producer. I don't think that's worth a 2 buzzers. A dog can be kept in a cage, and that's what I meant to say was a dog cage.
A dog cage.
Good try.
Thank you.
I'm sure the producers would like me to say there is no definitive answer. There's no right or wrong on this show. But I am right, and I say...
You are indeed. All right. That's 4 for you. We're at the end of the round. 4-0 score. John Favor, now this for you, America. Pay attention. Here we go. Round 2 coming up. Now, John, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'll take 8 this time.
It is 2 people played, Jonelle and McLean. Horrible Hank is really horrible.
How horrible is he?
Okay, they do it in unison. You'd almost think they were used to doing things in unison. He's so horrible, not only won't he change his mind, he won't change his blank. All right, John. Horrible Hank is really horrible. Not only won't he change his mind, he won't change his blank.
That's pretty odd.
Clothes.
Clothes.
Wait a minute.
Clothes is what he said. Let's see if he gets clothes over here. Jonelle.
Oh, I thought he wouldn't change his underwear.
Underwear.
Wait, there's going to be trouble here.
There is trouble.
Yeah.
Trouble in River City.
Because I put shorts, which could be underwear or Bermudas or... Thank you.
Now, Susan, you got a little catching up to do. That means you need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Here it is. Dumb Dora is really dumb.
How dumb is she?
How dumb is she?
See, that's the problem.
I know, but the timing's gone, Gene.
The timing is gone. Timing is gone. He, Dumb Dora is really dumb. Dumb Donald, I beg your pardon.
Well,
it makes a big difference.
There's a big difference.
You want the bandage on again?
Well, there is a difference, Gene, but let's talk about it at the cast party. Just keep talking.
Oh, all right. Dumb Donald's really dumb. He wanted to get hopped up, so he swallowed a blank. Here we go. Dumb Donald is really dumb. He wanted to get hopped up, so he swallowed a blank.
A rabbit. A hopping.
A rabbit.
Jumping rabbit. Bunny rabbit.
Rabbit.
What?
She said rabbits.
Oh.
That go hippity, hoppity, hippity, hoppity, as in Christopher Robin.
Down the bunny trail.
Right. There, yes, you've been reading those stories.
Yeah. Well, that's right.
And that's why I wrote Bunny Rabbit.
Aha! One for Susan. A. Milne.
Thanks to the passing time and the good Lord, I no longer have to read the Bunny Rabbit stories.
Right.
My children have gone beyond that age, but I did write Kangaroo.
Kangaroo. They do a little hopping.
Thank you, my jar. Look at those people in the back with the good taste.
All three of them.
The corrected chant.
A rabbit.
Oh!
Uh-huh. 4-2. I didn't think it was going to turn out this way. I'll level with you, Susan. What have you got?
Well, other things hop other than rabbits. I said a frog.
Frog. Now, you know, I thought everybody was going to say frog, and I'm wrong. I admit it. When I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I was wrong. I thought everybody'd say frog, and I am wrong.
Well, it's big of you to admit it, Gene. I put lawn. No, that's ridiculous. I put grass.
Grass.
No, I put pogo stick.
Pogo stick. All right, a bunny over there, so you got three of them all together. Come on down, John. Susan, you're going to be ruled off, but only temporarily. We'll see you later for game number 2. Here we go. Good luck to you, sir. You can win over $10,000 here. This is the way it goes. We polled the studio audience, nice, smart bunch like these, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Greener blank. And you know how it goes if you match 1, 2, or 3 there. Now let's see what sort of assistance you'll get from our stars. You can have Janelle McLean or Deborah Lee down here, or any of the three up there.
I'll start with Janelle. She's pretty.
So are you.
Thank you.
Well.
Greener pastures.
Greener pastures.
My favorite, Brett.
Is he cute?
Yes.
And he another person with good taste and perception. Greener than grass.
Greener than grass.
Okay, show us
don't
your
look at
well.
Him. McLean,
I don't
look
make
at
eye
him, because if you look intelligent, if you look smart and looking right at him...
I wasn't going to pick him. I'm not going to okay. Since he's giving me the eye, I'll go with McLean.
Oh, Lord, man, I got nothing here. Wait a minute.
Just want to come to him.
Just give me a minute.
Give
Greener's drugstore.
Greener. Greener within.
I don't know. Greener.
Throw him an answer, somebody.
Greener.
Greener. Greener Acres.
It's Greener.
Oh, no, I forget it.
Greener on the other side.
The grass is greener on the other side.
On the other side. Greener on the other side Acres.
Greener.
Give him the money. I don't care. What? Give him $500 and send him on his way.
Okay.
We'll have an answer.
Now,
I think you better.
You got a
we
choice here
noticed.
Now. As
Dolly
McLean
Green
said,
greener.
You can take the money now. That Dolly is $500.
Greener.
Or
greener.
Take his answer, you see, and take the $500 or try for the... No, I'm only kidding.
I go for the try. Pastures.
No, you got a choice. Answer. Your answer, one that's in your head, or one of the three they gave you.
Okay, I'm going to go with Janelle. Greener pastures.
Greener pastures.
Yes, Marco.
Right. Let's see if we've got greener pastures up there anywhere. Let's take a look at the $100 response. greener on the other side. He said that. Take a bow. All right, let's have a little round of applause for McClain. He was right all along. All right, let's take a look at the next one, please. Greener than grass.
Ah, that's one.
Yeah, Brett gave her that one. Last time for Greener Pastures, here we go. You got it. Attaboy.
Oh, my God. How are you doing?
All right.
She won me last
time. All right, now listen, you're going to have a chat at $5,000 right after this. Gonna have a shot at $5,000 here now, or $10,000 if you get a lucky spin of the wheel. Step up there, grab the peg, give it a pull, and we'll root for a double. Here we go. All right. Oh, it's gonna be a long spin. All right. $5,000 is not bad there, John. Here it is. Good luck to you. Remember, you have to match Brett. This is it. A fine blank. A fine blank.
Oh, I wish I were dead.
Well, wait a minute. Let's think about that a minute.
She's ready. If you match her, you get $5,000. What do you say to that? A fine blank.
I've got two. I'm going to go with a fine mess.
A fine mess.
Fine mess.
I don't think
John,
they're with you on
I
that one.
I kill myself. I thought because you were, I put a fine day.
A fine day. Was that
there
your second
so
one?
Many choices.
My second
was
the movie A Fine Madness. I was thinking of that. A fine.
You never thought of a fine day.
Fine what?
A fine romance was a great old song. Yeah. Well, see, but he's not in show business. He wouldn't think of that. And besides, it's not his generation either. It's yours.
Gee.
No, we're out to alienate everybody here. Yes. All right, John, you've got $500 and a shot at more money. Right now, we got to bring back Susan McCartney. Play game number two. If you're ready, we'll have a go at it and ask you to make the selection.
I'd like B.
B it is for you. Here it is. Mm-hmm. Brave Ben is really brave.
How brave is he?
Well, he's so brave, he's the only man in the world with enough nerve to give blank a hot foot. Susan, Brave Ben is really brave. He's the only man in the world with enough nerve to give blank a hot foot.
I'm going to say Frankenstein.
Frankenstein. Well, yes. He has big... He wore wedgies, didn't he? Let's face it.
He was the inventor of the wedgie, I believe.
Lead wedgies, that's right. What'd you say, Bill?
I said the Incredible Hulk.
The Incredible Hulk is a good response.
Thank you.
One good response
so far. Then why
did
they buzz?
Now I know he lost his last fight, but he's
just
still...
a short buzz would be required here.
Well, they
all
buzz.
Right, thank you. We miss it when you don't buzz. If you want to drop the whole thing altogether, we'd be happy to, because I'm tired of buzz. No, they didn't buzz.
Yes, they did buzz.
Yes, they did buzz.
Well, they did.
Yes, they buzzed. You said it was a good answer.
Yeah,
said,
the face is going
buzz?
And the hearing
and
is
the speech
gone.
Is going, too.
Eyes are not too good either.
Oh, if this show stays on the air, you should get your ears capped. I think the face is not enough.
All right, go.
Listen, I know this nice little home in Montecito where they take older people. I think you'd be awfully happy there. Muhammad Ali! Buzz, did you hear the buzzer?
Maybe did.
He didn't hear the buzzer.
Same deal, fella.
I like a buzz on once in a while.
Oh, we have.
Muhammad Ali.
M. Ali. All right. Susan is looking for the answer. Frankenstein. Not likely to find it here, but we must carry on anyway.
I said the big green one. The Incredible Hulk.
Right.
Yes, well, in keeping with not likely to find it here, I also said the Incredible Hulk.
Uh-huh. That seems to be the response, doesn't it?
No.
No?
I said Mean Joe Green.
Good. She's a real jock, isn't she? I mean, she really knows.
I like to play around.
Yes, of course. Really? All right. Now, you stand by for your round one question.
Minutes.
Now, this for you, if you please. All right. Join us next time for, 10 seconds. Oh, now 6, 5,
Brett doesn't
4,
know what the Pittsburgh
3,
Steelers are.
2, 1. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Bedsack. New ID and bed covering provides luxury upholstery for your old mattresses or box springs and protection for new, furnished by Bedsack. An electric trivet and easy meals without skimping on taste begin with Armor Star Ham. Tender, juicy ham, fully cooked and ready to use. Armor Star Ham. A calculator and Deep Woods Ought, the insect repellent that protects against extra tough mosquitoes and biting flies. A tray and Dentine chewing gum. While you're chewing Dentine, it freshens your breath as effectively as even mouthwash. Brush your breath with Dentine. A supply of quality automotive chemicals from the marketers of popular Quaker State motor oils. You'll be staying on the road with Quaker State. A picnic jug. And for a tasty change of pace, Lemon Tree, the lemonade flavored drink mix from Lipton, in low calorie and regular. And a calculator and Raid House and Garden Bug Killer. It kills bugs dead indoors and outdoors, yet won't harm most plants or shrubs. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tartman production. The program was edited for broadcast.